Hey guys, welcome to the video today. In today's video, I am going to set up and review this DVD player by this company On. We bought this at Walmart. And here's what the DVD player looks like, and here's what the remote looks like. And we'll take a closer look at those shortly when we take them out of the box. Here is what the bottom of the box looks like here. And then let's take a look at the back here. Here is some of the information on the back of the box. It talks about the basics, the specs, what's in the box, and this does come with a 4-foot HDMI cable, which is nice that they include that with the DVD player. So let me take everything out of the box and get it organized, and then I'll be back and we'll go from there. All right, guys, so here's everything that was inside of the box, and it all came with plastic packaging around it, which I've already removed and gotten rid of. A few of the items still have plastic on them that we're going to need to remove, and I'll talk about those shortly as I get to those items. So here is the DVD player, and this does have plastic around it that we're going to need to remove. This is the HDMI cable, and it has plastic covers on the ends that we're going to need to remove. And then here are the two AAA batteries that are wrapped in plastic. So we're going to need to remove the plastic from those AAA batteries. And then this is the AC USB adapter. This is the remote control. This is the quick start guide, and this is the product guide. And make sure that you read through all of this information before you do set up or use the On DVD player. These will tell you everything that you need to know on how to use the On DVD player both safely and properly. Okay, so I'm going to read through this information here, and then I'll be back and we'll take a closer look at the DVD player. All right, guys, so here is the front of the DVD player, and this is the disc door here. And then over here, this is the text-to-speech button. This is the eject button. This is the play pause button, and this is the power button. And then up here somewhere is where the display will be, and then over here somewhere is where the remote sensor is. All right, guys, so here's the back of the DVD player, and this is the power cord here. I'm gonna get that out of the way for now. And then up here, we have the component video, and then this is the coaxial audio, and then we have the composite video right here, and then the left and right audios right here. And then down here is where the HDMI is right here. So, okay, so now let's take a look at how to get the plastic off of the DVD player. All right, so there is a plastic covering here, and I've started it right here, started to get it off, and then, you know, just slowly work this off of the DVD player until you get the plastic off of the entire DVD player. So I'm going to finish that up now, and then I'll be back, and we'll go from there. All right, guys, so I've removed the plastic covering around the DVD player, and I've gotten rid of it, and this is what it looks like. And just take your time. It does take a while to get it all off, but just be patient and make sure that you do get all of the plastic off. Okay, so now let's take a closer look at how we're going to set the DVD player up. All right, guys, so we're going to install the batteries into the remote control first, and I've taken the plastic off of the batteries here, and I do plan on making a future video about this remote control and going over all the different buttons here. So if you want to learn about this remote control and what the different buttons do, please check back for that video, and when I make it, I'll link it at the end of this video. And if you're interested and have time, please check that video out. Okay, so on the back of the remote control here, here's the battery compartment cover. There's just a clip right here that we're going to gently push down on, and that allows us to take the battery compartment cover off like so. And then it shows us in here the correct direction for the batteries, so just make sure that you install the batteries the correct direction. I'm going to put this one in here first, and I'm putting the minus sign side of the battery in first like so, and then just gently pushing backwards on the spring until I can fit the front part of the battery down into the battery compartment. And then I'm going to take the next battery here, and I'm just putting the minus sign side of the battery in first on the spring down here. and then just gently pushing down on the spring until the front part of the battery can seat into place like so. And then I'm going to reinstall the battery compartment cover. I'm just lining this up like this and then gently pushing down here until the battery compartment cover clips into place like so. Okay, so now let's take a closer look at the DVD player and we're going to connect it to my TV. All right, guys, so the first thing that we're going to do is to hook the HDMI cable up to my TV. So I'm going to take these two plastic covers off here and get rid of those. And then I'm also going to take these wire ties here and take those off and get rid of those as well. Okay, there's one of them. And here is the other one, almost. There we go. Okay, so now I'm going to hook one end of the HDMI cable to the bottom of the DVD player where the HDMI output is, right there. And just make sure that you do fit this in the correct way, like so, and make sure that it's seated in there all the way. So let me go get rid of these wire ties and the covers that were on the HDMI cable, and I'll be back, and then we'll hook up the other end to my TV. All right, guys, and then I'm just going to plug in the other end of the HDMI cable into the HDMI input number one on our TV, and just make sure that you install this the correct direction and that it's seated in there all the way like so. All right, so now I'm going to plug the power cable into the AC USB adapter. And when you do this, just make sure that you plug it in the correct direction and make sure that it seats all the way into place like so. Now I'm going to plug this into an outlet and then I'll be back and we'll take a closer look at the DVD player. All right, guys, so the DVD player is plugged in and it shows off on the screen here. So I'm going to press the power button to turn the DVD player on. And then we'll see what the DVD player looks like on our TV screen. But before we do, let's see what the DVD player says here. And it looks like it's trying to load a DVD disc now, but I don't have one in there. And now it says no CD. So let's press the eject button to make sure that the disc door works, and we can see that it does. So I'm going to press the eject button again to close the disc door. And then let's take a look at the TV to see what the DVD player's user interface looks like. All right, guys, so this is what shows up on our TV screen right now, and we do not have a DVD in the DVD player. I'm going to press the setup button on the remote, and then this screen shows up here, and these are the different setting menus. The first one here is the system setup, and then this next one is the language setup, and then the next one is the video setup, and then the next one is the audio setup, and then the last one here is the digital setup. And each of these menus have different options in them that you can change if you want to. All right, guys, well, that's just about it for this video, and I hope it's been helpful, and thank you so much for watching. And I do plan on making future videos about this DVD player. I plan to make one on the remote about the different buttons on the remote and what they're for. And I also plan to make a troubleshooting video in case you're having problems with your DVD player not working and some steps that you might be able to try to hopefully resolve those issues. And when I do make those videos, I will link them at the end of this one. So if you're interested and have time, please check those videos out. Okay, so here's my opinion on the On DVD player. I think that it was reasonably priced, and I like the size of the DVD player, and I like that it came with an HDMI cable, and I think that it was easy to set up. So far, in my opinion, I'm overall really happy with this DVD player. Thank you again so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Have a good one. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, subscribe, and comment. And if you have the time, check out these other great videos.